G'day ladies and gents, Simon Brown here, doing a video understanding dividends for standard online share trading. Dividends, your share of a company's profit. First, we take the assumption a company needs to make a profit, and then they're going to do a couple of things with that profit. They will use some of it to pay off debt, they'll use some of it to expand operations, perhaps upgrade plant and equipment, perhaps even buy out competitors. And if they're a maturer company, they're going to take some of that profit and give it back to shareholders in the form of a dividend. Of course, particularly growth companies, smaller companies, they might make a profit, but they retain all of that profit to grow the business. Typically, your more mature companies, they're going to be paying out a dividend. They get declared with the results at interim and year-end stage. So every 6 months, any dividend, if at all, will be declared with those results announcements telling you what the dividend is and the important dates around the dividend. There are tax considerations with the dividend. We have a dividend withholding tax that came into effect in April 2012, replacing secondary tax on companies. It is a 15% dividend withholding tax, and it is paid directly to National Treasury. So if a company declares a 1 rand dividend, you will receive 85 cents. That other 15 cents is paid directly to Treasury, and there's no further tax consideration. Preference shares do pay dividends, so they're subject to the normal 15% dividend withholding tax. Important, property stocks pay interest as a rule. So the interest is paid to you in its entirety, but at the end of the year, when doing a tax return, you need to declare it as interest, and beyond the threshold, that interest is then taxable. Sometimes we get a script dividend. In other words, a company says, so we're going to give you a dividend, but if you will prefer, we will give you shares instead of a dividend. The shares will be given to you at zero value, so they impact your average purchase price. But what is critical here is that you usually get a slight premium. So if the dividend value is a rand, the share payment will be a rand and 5%, so 105 in essence. So you get that slight premium. Obviously, at the time of announcing the dividend, the terms will be declared as to how many shares and the like, and then you would have to elect. One or the other will be the default, either cash or shares. And standard online share trading, where your broker will contact you and say, which do you want? If you don't reply, you will get the default, but you can elect to receive whichever you would rather have. We also sometimes get a special dividend. In other words, a company has a policy of paying out a certain amount of their profit at interim stage and a certain amount of their profit at the end of year stage. Then they find themselves with an extra large amount of profit. Perhaps they're a mining company and suddenly commodity prices went through the roof. Perhaps they sold a business or something. They got money in that they don't normally generate. So they declare it as a special dividend. It's treated exactly the same as any other, except it's just that. It's special. Don't expect to get it every 6 months, every year. It's more of an infrequent occurrence. Sometimes, instead of a dividend, a company will pay you a share premium. Now, in terms of the dates and the amount of the dividend, exactly the same. But there is a key point. It's not taxed directly. It comes to you without having to pay any tax. Importantly, what it effectively does is reduce your purchase price. So if you'd bought a share at 30 rand and you get a 1 rand share premium, your purchase price for the share will be adjusted to reflect 29 rand. So there is an implication when you ultimately sell those shares, slightly cheaper purchase price, therefore more profit, assuming you've made a profit, and more potential tax on that profit. Some dividends will be declared in a foreign currency. Billiton, for example, Richemont, SAB Miller, they declare in a foreign currency, and then there is a currency conversion ratio. The dividend may be declared today, but their conversion ratio may only happen in a couple of weeks, maybe even a couple of months' time, when they say, well, we're paying you in US dollars, but the conversion will be 10 rand 75 per US dollar. So you've got to take the dollar, the conversion ratio, that tells you what you will get per share that you hold, and obviously subject to dividend withholding tax at 15%. Some important dates. First is the declared date. As I said, typically the dividend will be declared with results. I would say 99% of the time, in fact, even probably 99.9% of the time, dividends are declared with results. The next important date is last day to trade, LDT. You need to hold the shares at the close of business on that LDT in order to receive the dividend. When you buy them is not important, and when you sell them is not important. As long as you hold them at close of business on LDT, and typically that's going to be a Friday. Sometimes public holidays get in the way, but assuming it is a Friday, if you hold those shares, when the market closes on Friday, you will qualify for the dividend. If you only bought them in the morning, or if you bought them 5 years ago, you get the dividend. And you can sell them first thing Monday morning, as soon as we go what we call X date, the day after LDT. You can now sell those shares and still receive the dividend. As a rule, a share will fall by the dividend amount on the X date. So if a share's 25 Rand and the dividend's 1 Rand 50, on the X date, it will fall by that 1 Rand 50 and trade at 23 Rand and 50 cents. That's market dependent. If the market is very strong on that X date, it might not fall as much. The market is very weak, it may fall by a larger amount. And then, of course, pay date. That's the day we're really interested in. That is the day at which the money will be transferred into your broker account. It's transferred into the account in which the shares were held, and you will receive the dividends in that account. Remember, less 15% dividend withholding tax. A quick slide to illustrate the power of dividends. Far too many people sort of consider them not very important. So what we've got here is Standard Bank dividend over the last 10 years to the June 2013 results. Your red line, referenced on the left-hand side, is the cumulative dividend that you have received. And it's 35 Rand 85 cents that you've received over the entire period. The blue line is the dividend as it's been paid every 6 months for Standard Bank. But here's what's important. 10 years ago, you could have bought Standard Bank at around 30 Rand. And you've received dividends of 35.85. In other words, you have received more than the purchase price back in dividends, and you still hold those Standard Bank shares, which at the time of recording is around 120 Rand. So in the short term, dividends are often fairly small. It's not a massive amount of money that you might get in any one single day. But over the long term, dividends absolutely stack up and become critically important to investors.